Well, I think first of all, our young ladies played really, really hard. They played really aggressively. Thought it was a fast start to a great game, great rivalry. After the first quarter, I really didn't know if we could really slow them down. That certainly was a challenge for us. I think they run their offense with great tempo. They put you in some really tough spots. Everybody on their team essentially can post up. Everybody shoots it from the arc. They're all shooting a very high percentage. I think they were 3 of 4 or 4 of 5 from the arc in the first quarter. And so, you know, just had to find a way to kind of weather the storm to some extent, but also get better at what we needed to do to try to limit some good opportunities for them. You know, that being said, I think foul trouble, you know, helped us a little bit with that because Maya Selman wasn't in the second quarter. And at least I don't remember her being in, you know, or was Peyton Burkhardt. So that maybe gave us a little bit of momentum. But all in all, I thought our young ladies played really hard. I thought they played good basketball. Thought on the offensive end, we moved it, shared it. I think we had a number of young ladies play at a very high level. You know, I thought Hannah Shervin played really well on both ends of the court. In some limited minutes with foul trouble. Thought Kyah Watson made a lot of good things happen for us on both ends. Had a fun kind of tip-in foul at the end of the shot clock at one point in time. That was kind of a big play for us to kind of keep momentum going. Liv and Chloe, obviously, I think certainly not only can score the basketball, hit shots, but they defended at a really, really high level. Thought Maddie Kroll, who didn't score in the game, played really hard. Thought she did a lot of good things. I think she really helped us. You know, it really helped us taking care of the basketball, but also helped us on the defensive end in some assignments and coverages. So, and we had kids come off the bench and make really good things happen for us too. But I thought overall, as a team, I thought we played really hard and I thought we played really well against a very good opponent.
How big were Allison's minutes once Hannah and Natalie picked them?
Right. Hannah and Natalie both got in foul trouble. I thought Pep, then for two games in a row now, we call her Pep. I can't remember. If I call her Allison, it just seems weird to me. But Pep, I thought, played well, very well against NDSU, came in, gave us some really big minutes. You know, I think in this game, came in and did some really good things for us as well. But she's experienced. She knows. She's been in the program now for, I think, 4 years. And it's hard to know with all the COVID years and extra years of eligibility, but I think it's been 4 years for us. So she's very experienced, and I thought just played very soundly for us and helped and made a lot of good things happen.
What are your impressions of how Hannah controlled the glass then?
Hannah?
Yeah.
Hannah is someone who, on the offensive end, draws a lot of attention, and that opens things up on the perimeter. When we did miss some shots, I thought she did a great job of running around kids, trying to get offensive rebounds, keep things alive. So she was able to score it inside at times. She was able to kick it out at other times. She was able to get us offensive boards. But I think on the defensive end, Hannah really makes a difference because she can kind of clean up some rebounds that way. I thought she did a really good job kind of helping, moving, seeing the ball, defending on the perimeter and stretches. So I thought overall maybe the most overall best performance for Hannah in her career at this point in time. I think she just played really, really hard, played really well.
Obviously defense is, you know, a big part of this game, but you know, as far as the offense goes, do you feel like you're really, you know, in your stride to a point where this is where you envision the offense to be at the end of non-conference play?
Well, I think for us offensively, we have a number of young ladies who can score. We can move the ball, share the ball, swing the ball, and we can find a number of different kids who can make shots for us. And we had a stretch where we weren't scoring it kind of later in that game, but we were getting really good looks at that point in time. So that's ultimately, that could happen. But I thought our kids did a good job of trying to attack, but also be smart in attacking. You know, I think the way we defended takes a lot of energy out of you, and it's hard to just push the ball up the court and try to score as fast as possible on the offensive end too when you're using that much on the defensive end. So I thought, you know, we tried to push it, and I think we got Grace in a layup scenario. I think Macy kind of after a press, we got a quick shot. But beyond that, we didn't get as many quick opportunities, but I thought, you know, we needed to find a way to kind of catch our breath a little bit and kind of, you know, not that you're relaxing on the offensive end because you still want to attack, but you got to find a way to save, conserve a little bit of energy.
Liv seemed exhausted at the end of the first half. Is that something you noticed from your entire team, that they were perhaps running even faster today?
Well, I think so. I think there's an emotional side to it too, but I also think Liv is someone, when you watch her play, and Liv has been a great example in our program over time of working and being diligent about your work and trusting the process. And then last year everyone said, oh, where did she come from? Well, she had quietly been working throughout the course of her career, and then really came on strong last year. And now you see Liv at a whole new level on the defensive end. She was a good defender before, but now she's really, really tough defensively. And so that just takes so much. There's not a player that gives more than Liv Korngable. She is someone who plays all out hard on every possession.
What does it say about your team that without even really shooting that much, you know, someone like Kyah can score, you know, seeing high points and, you know, kind of contribute to the offensive whole?
Yeah, Kyah is someone who I think is great for us on the defensive end because she can guard almost every position. I think it becomes tougher for her sometimes, you know, with some bigger post kids, but she's so strong, she's so athletic, yet she really helps us on that. And on the offensive end, she's just figuring it out at this point in time. But again, she didn't get to play a whole lot last year, so those pieces are really coming. I think her first two threes for us were big threes to kind of calm everybody's nerves and say, okay, they're making threes, I guess we can do that too. And so that was really, really big for her, but also really big for our team.
Obviously, it's pretty early in the conference schedule, but is it possible that this is the best team that you've coached here at USC?
Well, this is the best we've ever defended anybody, you know, and I think this is something that this group, you really have to be as a player. It has to be something that you want it so badly defensively to be able to perform that way, because like we said, it takes a lot out of you. And so certainly I believe this team can be a really solid, and they've shown that in stretches, a really solid offensive team. It's hard when you compare the numbers of our offense compared to teams that we've maybe coached in the past here, because we're on defense for a long time. So those numbers could be skewed a little bit in that way, but certainly defensively, I think our young ladies are playing at a very high level. And offensively, we're taking care of the basketball. Our percentages are really good.
What was the adjustment defensively that really started slowing down the Jackrabbits?
Well, I thought we missed some assignments in the first quarter. And I think certainly South Dakota State is really well coached. So they made adjustments to how they ran different things. And that we didn't know it was coming, they got us on it. There was a handoff play for Paige Myers early, and they hit a three on it. And so now we had to make an adjustment to that. They set some ball screens where Vlashin was setting ball screens for Paige Meyer, and we hadn't seen a whole lot of that. And we had to learn how to make an adjustment to those kind of things. They got out of some of their dribble handoff stuff and ran some of their things a little bit differently. And so some of that just took time to adjust. To it, you know, they went back to a baseline out of bounds play that they really had a lot of success against us with last year, and haven't really run it much this year, maybe not at all this year that I've seen. So, you know, like they're really smart, and they kept making adjustments and put us in spots that we hadn't seen much of or any of this year at some of that. So that took a little bit of time to try to figure out what we're going to do. Where have you been? We've missed you. Welcome back.
Thank you. You kind of touched on some of the qualities, but are there unique qualities that make this defense, as you said, even one of the best you have?
Well, I think they communicate really well on the court, and they're making adjustments, and so you'll see them a lot of times after scenarios, after timeouts, if that's the case, or even after a play happens on the court, they're talking to each other about, hey, we're going to have to switch that. We're going to have to beat that. We've got to move to the ball. You're going to have to get matched up quicker, whatever the case is. And so I think because they have a very high defensive IQ, you know, I think a lot of times when you talk about players and teams, you talk about their offensive IQ. I think this team and these players understand how to do some things defensively. And there were a couple possessions. There was a possession late in the game when my selling came off a ball screen, and Kyah and Hannah were involved in it. And Kyah got over the ball screen, and then Burkhart set another one for her, and we didn't practice that. We hadn't really seen that. And then Hannah said, well, I'll switch it. Well, then Burkhart rolled, and then Kyah was kind of caught in a tough spot, and then Hannah came over and made the shot really tough. And it's just those kind of plays, I think, are plays that this team, because these kids are experienced, because they understand, they're making some plays that they just see it, and they're finding ways to recover and get back to kids and scramble around, and that it's really fun to watch at times.
Well, Kyah, season high for you. I guess what's going right for you out there?
I would say just my shots were falling and just getting open looks from everyone on the court moving around, so made it easier.
What openings did SDSU offer in that second quarter? Obviously, that's when things started opening up for you.
I think we just played very well together. I think having Kyah being so dynamic, being able to score inside and outside and in the mid-range makes it a glorious opportunity for anyone and any spot on the floor.
Did you guys prepare for there to be a lot of long rebounds? Because it seemed like you guys were pretty much on top of every single thing that bounced out into the perimeter.
I think that's just something that we work on most days is boxing out, rebounding, watching the flight of the ball. And so, you know, Kyah and Han are big in there. And then, you know, Pep and Jen and when they come in. So it's an area of focus for sure.
Perimeter player, but what was Hannah's impact on this game?
I think more than anything, this was our best game where Hannah and Kyah have limited their post touches. So defensively, I would say, but offensively, Hannah's giant in the post, and that causes a lot of attention. With Kyah blasting too, that causes attention. And then, you know, us on the perimeter, we get to reap the benefits of their hard work.
When Han is that dominant in the game, just, you know, on the rebounding perspective, is it tough for you guys to lose?
That would be hard to lose.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we'd have to go, you know, 0-for from the arc for that to happen.
Kind of watching one of these games is, I have to imagine, it's so different, but when you're out there actually playing in a rivalry game, I have to imagine that's a whole different animal for you, wasn't it?
You know, it was exciting being out there, just like the crowd and everything, being into it, us being excited every play, but, you know, it's just another game. It's how we go into them, so, but it was still very fun.
Were there times early on, especially once you hit those first couple threes, and I imagine that, yeah, you're really fired up. Do you kind of have to remind yourself of what you just said, that this is just a rivalry game, this is just another game, it's not anything more than it is?
I mean, I would say, like being confident and still looking to score, but also, like, knowing that I can draw attention and then find an opening for another girl. So just playing unselfish. Yeah.